children and youth of UCC Midland are excited to lead this special service. At this time, we build community by sharing personal joys, concerns, and church-related announcements. Brandon will bring the microphone to those who wish to share.
Jen Minette, I'm asking for prayers for my sister and her children. This past Thursday, my brother-in-law passed away. He had long had heart issues, but he had actually been doing really well, so this came as quite a shock. He had a cold, and he laid down for a nap and just didn't wake up. So, prayers.
Church member Deb Boots ended up having emergency gallbladder surgery this past week, so we hold Deb in our prayers as she recovers. And then Margaret Clark has requested prayers for Margaret and Basil's sister-in-law, Paula Clark. She is going to be having a liver transplant surgery on December 12th in Dallas, Texas. So please keep Paula in your prayers as well.
Nothing as serious as those two things by any means. Two things. One, the pregnancies in our family of Justin and Sue's are going fantastically, as is the pregnancy of Jason and Jocelyn. And then there is a way more laid back one, which is at the women's gather, at the women's meeting, I received the most delightful, I really do love them, Santa Claus and Mrs. Claus ornaments, and I would love to know if there is a story behind them.
And yesterday was Kate's birthday.
In the church parlor.
I'm gonna have another baby cousin. Sharing the peace and joy of God.
and the responsive call to worship found in your bulletin. We come together in these dark days.
We give us to you now, to light our mornings and our evenings.
We come seeking renewed joy.
We can look now to each other for our spirits to be improved.
We come carrying gifts along with the burdens of the year.
We now look within to bring tidings of great joy.
Thank you.
love, bit by bit, one flicker at a time, until there is no more darkness. Amen.
We will begin our program, Twas the Season Before Christmas, and I would like to invite up our Red Door Sunday School class and our Green Door Sunday School class to sing our first song.
Twas the season before Christmas, but what does that mean? Weeks of waiting and watching, but what's to be seen? A wreath and some candles lit one by one, reminding each heart there is work to be done. The baby is coming, he's coming again. Year after year, more than 200 times 10. We must make it special, but what do we do? We repeat the same things, but we make it feel new. Life rushes along with speed and loud clatter. How can we make these special weeks matter? It's easy to get caught in the crazy mad dash. Worn out and tired, we think we might crash.
Oh, is that about presents and candy and fun? The lights on the trees are as bright as the sun. Think sparkle and glitter as they blow us away from the real meaning of joy on our Christmas Day.
Let's take a few minutes to focus and learn about what we can do, and I'll take a turn. To remember the purpose of Advent today, to seek to fill up in a meaningful way.
Thank you.
We've got just 4 weeks to make some room to allow Jesus in and let the room. Traditionally, it's hope, peace, joy, and love, but there are many different ways to focus above.
Remember those candles lit one by one, helping them see there is work to be done. Advent is more than just waiting, it's praying, loving, and peace creating.
Back to that green. There's more than just green, other colors are present. What do they mean? Depends on the church. You could see blue, white, or red. Purple represents the crown of Jesus' head.
The candle of hope is the first one we light, a glimmer of hope in the darkness of night. A royal purple candle says, pray and prepare. Lay down your worries, don't forget God is there.
Life gets so busy, unclear though steady. Advent is a gift, a chance to get ready. Remember the story isn't over yet. The candle of hope said,
I'm a sure bet.
Week to come around and another candle's lit. We keep adding light a little more bit by bit. Two purple candles say prayer and prepare. Find a peaceful moment. No God is there.
Many things make us worried or even feel stressed. Finding peace seems to be elusive at best. Sleeping baby Jesus, as we all need a rest, the candle of peace.
Take a deep breath.
One of these things here isn't the same. Do you notice the difference? Let's make it a game. Two purple candles and a candle that's pink. The third Sunday of Advent is most fun, I think.
Family traditions are a piece of the pie. Find moments of happiness and let out a sigh. The ways that giggle and a laugh that is hearty, the candle of joy says,
that's how we party.
The candle of love is candle number four, adding light, bright, and bold like a lamp at the door. For candles glowing bright, vibrant, and new, find ways to be loving, let God's love shine through.
In a world where we see so many things that are sad, and sometimes they make us feel just so darn mad, the light of these candles can make us more glad, the candle of love says,
this is so bad.
There's still one more candle that ain't too far away. It's yes and all to happen and dark Christmas Day. Up your right candle, up your right day, remind of what happened on our starry night.
A baby is coming, he's coming again, year after year, more than 200 times 10. This is what's special, but it's nothing new. The candle of Christ says,
I'll always love you.
'Twas the season before Christmas, now we know what Advent means. 4 weeks to get ready, pink, purple, and green. A wreath and some candles lit one by one, reminding each heart there's work to be done.
Thank you. God's people would realize that God had shown them love. Their joy over God's goodness would then cause them to give thanks and trust in God. In those moments, they would have so much joy, they would cry aloud and shout, because they knew God was with them. Isaiah prophesied, "You will say on that day, I thank you, Lord. Though you were angry with me, your anger turned away, and you comforted me. God is indeed my salvation, and I will trust and won't be afraid. Yea, the Lord is my strength and shield. He has become my salvation. You will draw water with joy from the springs of salvation, and you will say on that day, thank the Lord, call on his name, proclaim God's deeds among the peoples, declare that God's name is exalted. Sing to the Lord who has done glorious things, proclaim this throughout all the earth. Shout and sing for joy, city of Zion, because the Holy One of Israel is great among you. Let us give thanks and trust in God. Let this be a time when we realize the love that God has shown us and shout with joy that God is with us. Please stand as you are able and join in singing hymn 165, Love Came Down in Christmas.
Generous God, you have given us all that we have and all that we are. Thank you for the opportunity to respond to your love and the generosity by sharing our gifts with others. Our hearts sing with joy as we work with you to bring true peace and justice to our world. As we prepare for the coming of your Son, May our lives proclaim your good news for all throughout the earth. Amen.